The AFP has been accused of having blood on their hands and sacrificing the lives of two young Australians. And finally, they've explained why they dobbed in Bali 9 duo Andrew Chan and Myron Sukumaran. Take a look.
This is the police officer who will forever carry the burden of the Bali 9. Mike Feeland, now Deputy Commissioner, made the decision to share information with Indonesian authorities, a decision he made knowing Australians could face the death penalty.
If anybody thinks that over the last 10 years I haven't agonised over this decision, then they don't know me and they don't know what it's like.
But it's a decision he says he'd make again.
Given what I knew at that particular time and what our officers knew, I would take a lot of convincing to make a different decision.
In the wake of the executions, AFP Commissioner Mike Colvin says their hearts go out to the Chan and Sukumaran families, but he says they don't deserve an apology from federal police.
I mean, we can't apologise for the role that we have to try and stop illicit drugs from coming to this community.
Admitting while they knew some details of the Bali syndicate before they left the country, it was not enough to stop them.
I can assure you that if we had enough information to arrest the Bali 9 before they left Australia, we would have done just that.
There are already tighter guidelines in place for the AFP when dealing with cases that could attract the death penalty overseas, but still today, no guarantees the same situation couldn't happen again.
I wish I could assure you that this scenario could never happen again, but I cannot.
Angela, what do you think of this?
I still think they have blood on their hands.
Do
I'm
you?
Sorry, I do. I really do. And I learned from that press conference yesterday that one of the members of that AFP team actually asked to be taken off the job because he knew that the end result might be that some of that of the members of the Bali 9 might end up facing the death penalty. And they did.
I'm with you, Ange, because I do... but though I think you couldn't help but be moved by that Deputy Commissioner's plight, where you did very much get a sense that he really grappled with the decision that he made. And in hindsight, I'm sure he does regret it, but when you're a police officer and you can't police on variables, they wouldn't be knowing that this might happen, this might happen, this might happen. I wonder, I mean, the guidelines have changed, I think, which is very good, so the police, the AFP, are not put in a similar position again. I wonder, though, if they should be... if the guidelines should be even more apparent, that you really... it has to be a ministerial directive if this information is going to be passed on to a country that has the death penalty that involves Australian citizens.
Here's my thing, I'm maybe hopelessly naive on this. Why couldn't they have been arrested when they returned to Australia?
They had said this. They basically said that they couldn't arrest them before they left Australia. Firstly, they said that the information that was passed on to them from Scott Rush's via sort of Scott Rush's father, via the barrister, that this actually never even made it to Jakarta. It was already the subject of an investigation that they were undertaking, and they were already watching these people. They had they have arrangements in place that we've had in place with Indonesia since the Bali bombings, stuff like that. It's worked really, really well. It's been very good at preventing terrorism, and part of that
wait until they came home, Joe. That's
why prevent the thing in the first place.
I think they sort of felt that they didn't know that they would be able to someone like me. It seems obvious, but we don't know. But they were obliged to pass this information on. If the Indonesian authorities had found out that these guys were trafficking all these drugs through Indonesia, committing this terrible crime, and then found out the Australians knew about it and did nothing, that would have been considered a terrible slight on them and a betrayal of those arrangements and those sharing, and may have stopped them from sharing information with us, could have prevented a terrorist attack that could have could have saved Australian lives. And so, you know, and back in 10 years ago, these guys were hardcore drug runners who were forcing other people to risk their lives and risk the death penalty to carry out massive amounts of drugs, heroin. It's not a benign drug. So they weren't the best guys in the world. They weren't the martyrs that they are today. So let's cut them a break.
But they did rehabilitate. And
let's look at some feedback on this topic this morning with the AFP. And from Anne, the AFP should not have to apologise for doing their jobs. I feel so sorry for these wonderful police. They are damned if they do and damned if they don't.
Yeah,
and this one from Sonia. The drug mules are arrested, yet the drug cartels and drug syndicates are free, like the kingpin who's free in Sydney. That is so incredibly true. And finally, from Jared, I support the AFP's actions, but a lot of you with these hardline opinions would be sounding completely different if your family was in the Bali duo's position.
It's also a great point.